some of the work that we do at Beca is public consultation. And one of the challenges of public consultation is getting all parts of the community to respond. And we know that some parts of the community, you know, English can be a second language, or culturally the tradition is not to, you know, respond on web forms and emails and things like that. Tala itself was created just at the beginning of the year. And so it was a sort of a 2-month process to take it from beginning through to actually getting the results of the focus groups that we ran. I think one of the things we discovered in building this AI is that you really have to have people that understand the community who's going to use the AI. So if I tried to do it by myself, it just wouldn't have worked. I wouldn't have understood the culture. Luke Fitzpatrick, he's a member of the community, and that was invaluable. As I say, we couldn't have done it without Luke. When we started off, I thought the big challenge would actually be just getting an accurate translation, because the AI is used to working in English, and so we were getting it to live translate into Samoan and back from Samoan. What we found is actually it wasn't the accuracy of the translation that was important, it was the appropriateness. And Luke did a lot of work working out how to make the AI have the appropriate levels of respect in the way it talked. And that balance between formal Samoan and casual Samoan was a big challenge. And so what we found was there was a growing preference for using casual Samoan in the younger members of the community. And so we're looking at that, you know, do we need to do something to take note of that? So we would love, you know, local councils and government agencies to start using Tala. I think Samoan is the third largest spoken language in New Zealand. What we'd like to do is for it to kind of just be something extra that we can do to make sure we get the views and the ideas coming out of the Samoan community.